Have you heard the word sapata before? Sapata, or spells, or vows, or oaths, technically is a paragraph of prayer and at the same time cursing that was pledged by Sang Makudur or Dukun to gods and deities in order to protect the land of Sima or freehold land from the wrongdoers. Perdang in his article stated that sapata became one of the must included part in every Sima inscription. There were so many kinds of punishment that Makudur asked to God and deities in sapata. In Manti Asi one inscription, for example, Makudur asked for death caused by hit and smashed till died by invisible creatures, dragged down into the water and beaten by crocodiles, attacked and beaten by snakes, and etc. This is a rare phenomenon. In Sriwijayan inscription, people who disobeyed the rules that had been carved in the inscription would be punished by gods. And the punishment they would have was similar with the Javanese hit and smash till die by invisible creatures punishment. But none of them included animals to be the executor of the punishment. This topic becomes more interesting because in ancient Javanese inscriptions, there are inscriptions which mention animals to become the executor, but only a few. Not all inscriptions mention the animals. However, this phenomenon could still be found up until the ancient Balinese era. It makes me question about why some animals were mentioned in sapata of the Sima inscriptions to be the punishment givers to wrongdoers. My name is Mawal Alexander Arifa, and with my partner Mimi Susanti, and this is our article with the title Animals on Sapata of Sima Inscription from the period of Rakai Watukara Diah Balitus Reign from 900 to 920 Anno Domini. Prasasti Teru I Tepusan became the very first Sima inscription that included sapata in it. Since the very first sapata in ancient Javanese era came from ancient Mataram Kingdom, I thought it would be good if we seek for an answer from where it came for the first time. And the reason I chose the period of Rakai Watukara Diah Balitung is because Diah Balitung was the king who published the most inscription in ancient Mataram Kingdom in the history. And he published about up to 40 inscriptions. I guess it could give a better perspective since he who published the most inscriptions. Back to my aims. My missions here are first to identify the variety of animals that is mentioned on sapata of Sima inscriptions from the period of Rakai Watukara Diah Balitung Reign, and second, to discover the reasons behind the mentioning. So, how about the research method that I used to find the answer?
Basically, there are three basic steps of method that I used. First, data gathering step, which collects all the data needed, like the primary and secondary data, also with other additional sources of knowledge. Second, data processing step, which analyzes all data that has been collected. And third, data interpreting step, which all the data that has been analyzed be interpreted under two main concepts that is proposed by writer. First, the Rajadharma and Danda concept, and also the contemporary social control concept by Michel Foucault. I have checked about 40 inscriptions dated from Diah Balitung Reign, and I only got 4 inscriptions that mention animals on sapata part. There are Kubu-Kubu inscriptions, Rukam inscription, Sang-Sang inscription, and Manti Asihwan inscription. Here are the list of animals that was mentioned in each inscription. There are snake, tiger, sea monster or tuiran, crocodile, eel or pelut Indonesia, or pesut, dolphin, water snake or ula lampai, and still unknown animal or mangalu. First, animals that were mentioned in sapata are classified as the threatening animals they ever knew. For example, crocodile, snake, and tiger became the most mentioned animals, and we know that these are threatening animals up until now. Second, these chosen animals are not ordinary animals. It seems like there is spiritual connection among human and the chosen animals. One of the example can be found in Manti Asihuan inscription, which snake and mangalu was called as Didi. Next, according to ethnographic research conducted by Robert Westing in 1990 until 2000s, noted that Javanese people consider tiger as a sacred animal, especially people from East Java, for its specialty and its power. So, by seeing the fact, I assume that these animals were chosen because not only for their frightening faces, but also its sacredness. Third, the king had an authority to control his people based on what Rajadharma manuscript had told, so that Dharma would always be obeyed. In Rajadharma, the king should be the guardian of Dharma. In order to do so, the king had a right to punish his people so that no one would disobey. That is why Danda existed. Danda means to punish in English. From Danda, the king believed that there should always be punishment so that no one will disobey Dharma. Fourth, it came up there were social control happened by controlling their sense of fear, using the fear to these animals to ensure that no one disobeyed the king. And this social controlling practice mixed up Hinduism belief and Javanese local belief. The result of this research shows that there was a relationship between the Hindu belief and local belief that mixed up and created a new understanding about who had the right to give punishment to wrongdoers. Javanese local belief believed nature spirits existed and became the judges for every action that human made. They manifested themselves to some kind of animal which considered sacred, and at the same point, they had control to maintain order and also dharma.
So after all, the spirits took form, becoming animals, had the equal right to punish the wrongdoers alongside with gods and deities in Hinduism belief. That's the end of my presentation. Thank you for your nice attention and have a good day.